When does a hero's journey begin? The moment you step outside the safety of your homes? Or when you realize the fight has just begun? Is it when you comprehend how small you are compared to the vastness?
Welcome to episode 1 of The Creators. This is a special series that is going to highlight individual content creators within the community. It's going to start out as a 10-part mini-series. Now, episode 1, while would be better used for a content creator, is actually, in my opinion, going to be used to do a kind of like a public service announcement. This one's going to be dedicated to our fans, because it's the one thing all content creators have in common, aside from our drive, our dedication, our sheer will, what we're willing to invest. The only real common denominator is our fans. And while we all have our fans, one definitely stands out among the most, and that's KWheels. KWheels, or better known on Twitter by the handle as Kevin Wheeler, is one of a well-known supporter of not just myself, but of many creators. Kevin has been there for me in particular from the very beginning, and I class him as the godfather of the channel, as he was my first donation, my first Patreon, and my first fan mail. Even when he's told he doesn't have to, his dedication to everyone and everything is virtually unwavering. So who is Kevin? Well, Kevin's magic origins come from a more darker nature. As an employee of a halfway house, he helped those in need, and in turn, they ignited his spark. This confused Kevin, disoriented, sliding through the blind eternities. He found himself in the middle of a battle on Zendikar. There he met up with various other creators, planeswalkers, if you will, who helped teach him the finer points of Magic the Gathering. He found himself learning how to construct, build, and play Magic the Gathering, and this led him to trade. And the rest, you can say, is history. He became well known throughout the multiverse, coming across the big ones like Cyban Lore and Unsleeved Media. He eventually came to my aid, learning, passing on, and then ultimately finding the rest of the content creators. He continues to this day, hopping from channel to channel, supporting everyone he meets, voicing his concerns or his displeasures, praising people where they deserve it. Donates, he subscribes, and more importantly, he sends out signed merchandise. I feel it's worth noting because it's fans like this where we can enjoy drama-less interactions with our fans. We can go on our day doing what we love, creating, talking, being there for one another, just like Kevin is. And if Kevin has taught me anything, it's that to be patient and be wise. Because even when Kevin is upset, he takes the time to see things through. So if I can pass anything on to the fans, it's that even if you don't see content for a short amount of time, it doesn't mean that that person's gone. They could be working on something big or stellar. I've noticed in the year I've been doing this that I'll gain 3 subs, I'll lose 4, I'll gain 2, I'll lose 3, and it's been an uphill battle. I'm currently sitting at 178 subs, and if people weren't leaving, it'd probably be around 220. What I'm trying to say is that stick in there. Wait it out. And if something happens you don't like, not just with me, but with anyone, voice your concern, because us as creators listen to everything. I didn't actually believe it when I heard the professor say that he reads all his comments on YouTube or Twitter, because I couldn't imagine someone who has so many followers taking the time to read it. But I realized that as I went on, I found myself doing the exact same thing, following Twitter chains, following comments, and it led me to, change. Unfortunately for some, this wasn't enough, and I ended up on a block list. And I found that block list is not something I should be displeased with, because when I do a deep dive on certain personalities, I check their friends out just like they did with me to block me, and I found that it wasn't very nice on the other side of that list. So, as I said, if you have something to say, please say it. Bring it forward. We may not respond immediately because we may be processing what you said, or we may lash out, but don't take this personally. This is a very, very stressful hobby. And for me, it's a hobby. For some, it may be a job, a career, something that they've put their last ounce of hope into. Which reminds me of a quote I heard once upon a time. Hope is the greatest of human emotion, and without hope, we are nothing. Never take someone's hope. Well, in some cases this is true. In others, it may be warranted. Sometimes you have to take that hope for somebody to come to the terms or come to realizations that something needs to be changed. And that's what I'm going to do about this. It's my hope that when I talk about certain creators that they'll enjoy it, that they'll find that it's reciprocating, that it'll be friendly in nature, and, most people will probably be taken by surprise and be like, wow, I can't believe you actually took the time to do this. So stay in touch. Keep an eye out soon, because all those episodes are coming to you. So for you, Kevin, I dedicate this video, the first in a series where I'll bring to light those who create Magic the Gathering content, both good and bad. So this is The Creators, and I'm your host, Jay, the Filthy Casual. I'm Jay, the Filthy Casual, former Knight of the Roundtable, and member of the Phoenix Syndicate. Thank you for watching. If you like this video and would like to see more like it, click the like button and subscribe. To be notified, don't forget the bell, because we all know YouTube won't do it. If you would like to support the cause further, you can donate at the links below. And I would like to thank the current supporters, because without you, this wouldn't be possible. And remember to support your local game store, as they are in the brick and mortar of the games community. I'm Jay the Filthy Casual, and thanks for stopping by.